Hello friends. Today's video is going to be slightly different because it is Samhain, more commonly known as Halloween these days, and just wanted to share some thoughts about it. So as many of you know, I was raised in the Latter-day Saint Church, also known as Mormons, and my dad had some pretty, I would say, extreme views about Halloween, about Samhain. So when I was really young, I remember we did do Halloween things. We went trick-or-treating, we dressed up in costumes, but about the time, let's see, I think it was about the time I was 10, Dad decided that Halloween was evil. And instead, we transitioned to having a family harvest celebration, which was different. Instead of going trick-or-treating, doing the Halloween-type things, we would watch movies together, and we would have a personally developed religious celebration, is the best way I can describe it without getting too bogged down on it. So as an adult, I find myself having a very strange relationship with this time of year, with this celebration. Several years ago, when I started studying, well, more like almost 10 years ago now, when I started studying tarot, paganism, all of the various folk healing practices, I started learning about what Samhain actually is, which is a day of transitions. A time where you reflect on the year that you've had and prepare to go into the dark time of the year, a time of contemplation, a time of remembrance, where it's a day that is used to connect with your ancestors. So it's very interesting to me that my father, who was so opposed to the holiday, actually did a lot of the same things, just used different words for it. But now, as an adult, I find myself looking at a lot of the celebrations, a lot of the activities, and thinking's not the right word. I find myself feeling like I don't belong, like it doesn't fit. Which brings me to my thoughts for this year. Because this year, my cousins invited me to assist them for the church trunk or treat, where I hid in the back of the car and was the voice for their, they have a skeleton prop that has a microphone inside of it, or yeah, a microphone and a speaker inside of it. And so I hid in the back of the car and I talked to the kids as they came to get their candy through the skull. Which, as you can probably tell, just before I've even said anything, I have really enjoyed. But when I was first invited, I was like, yes, because you are the people who are asking me, because it was two specific cousins. Yes, I will do this. I'm kind of grumpy about it, but I'll do it. But then I actually got into it. I got into the experience, and I had so much fun. So I've been thinking a lot since that, because that was last weekend. So it was several days before the actual day of Halloween, of Samhain, but I'm seeking I have some things to leave in the past still. Which, to be fair, we all do. We're all learning. We're all growing. But for me, I'm realizing I need to build my own traditions. I need to re-examine my thoughts about, and my memories about, some of my past. Because when I look back on really holidays in general, they were not pleasant times for me. They were difficult. Fifth child out of seven, big family, large age gaps. So holidays always felt like an obligation, not something to be enjoyed, at least in my conscious memory. For myself, for Samhain this year, I'm having a very quiet, contemplative time. But I was able to enjoy some of the holiday too. Just some thoughts about this time of year, this holiday. Thank you for sticking around and listening to me pontificate for a bit. Let me know what your own thoughts about Samhain are, your own holiday, Halloween celebrations. And until next time. Walk in the light, my friends. Bye.